also showing some, okay, the cost of each to be back with an, I will be back with an interesting video. Yet another interesting episode.
Hi guys, welcome back to the Blush Talks. Thanks a lot for showing so much love to the first part of the Vietnam trip vlog. If you haven't watched it already, I will put the link to the first part down in the description box below. So you can go down, watch the first part and then come back, watch the second part. That's simple, isn't it? I was also asked by some of my friends and colleagues that how much did we actually spend on our entire trip. So even if I have added bits and pieces of, you know, the prices at every point of the video, I would say, I can safely say that we spent around 60,000 rupees per person for the 8 days that we spent in Vietnam. That included our airfares, our hotel reservations, food, shopping, commute, also going, traveling to touristy places. So all inclusive, we spent about 60,000 per person. If you want more detailed breakdown of how much we spent, that detailed description, you can comment down in the comment box below and I will be able to answer to your question.
After exploring the massive city and culture vibe in Hanoi, it's time for us to visit the beautiful mountain trails in the Sapa Valley. We took a bus from the Hanoi city to Sapa, which was a journey of about 5 hours. And it costed us $10 for each ticket. It was called the sleeping bus, something that I have never seen in my life. The route to Sapa was quite scenic. In fact, it reminded me of our Indian states like Goa and Kerala. We reached Sapa just about the lunchtime and took a 10 minutes walk around the Sapa lake to our hotel. We were booked with a Sapa village resort that was located right across the lake. This hotel had a splendid mountain view straight from our rooms. We had booked a family room and a couple room. The couple room costed us about 6,000 INR.
So pretty.
With less than a day in our hands, we wanted to make the best out of our trip here in Sapa. Though a quaint little town, Sapa can offer the peaceful vibe and at the same time a city full of entertainment, all in one. After a cup of coffee by the lakeside, we walked to explore the marketplace and the only mall of the town, the Sun Plaza City Center. Here we accidentally found out the mountain rails and decided to take a ride the next morning.
Baby, hey, that's it.
Our evening here winded up with some rain and a sumptuous dinner. It is the next morning and the time for the most exciting train ride. We reached the Sapa Mountain Rail Station, booked the tickets and boarded this beautiful train. Took just one part of the train ride that costed us about 250 INR. This was probably the most beautiful 4 minutes of a train journey. We got down at the Mong Hua station, clicked a couple of pictures and took another train back to the Sapa station. It was time to bid Sapa adieu. But before catching a bus, we had an awesome Japanese lunch at the Sakura restaurant. With its warm ambience and yummy-licious food, this place is a must visit if you are in Sapa. Our next destination was the mesmerizing Vietnamese island Phu Quoc. This island is known for its white sand beaches and its amazing resorts. We took a flight to Phu Quoc from Hanoi and each ticket costed us 6,000 INR. We stayed in the Kamia resort, which was located towards the northern edge of the island. This place was away from the city center and we were blown away by how huge it was. It had a sloping pattern that enabled a stunning view to the ocean right from the rooms. Very tired from the journey, we decided to call it a night early and woke up to this magnificent view the next morning. I cannot describe in words how beautiful, calm and serene the place looked. Having breakfast, we took a cab and reached the Sun World Cable Car Center. I was super excited as this was my first cable car ride ever. And FYI, this is world's longest cable car that transported us from the southern part of Phu Quoc Island to another island called the Pineapple. It was a thrilling ride floating between the giant columns erected in the sea. Trust me, the aerial view of clouds, sun, and the vastness of the sea is definitely an experience unmatched. Our last and final destination of the Vietnam trip was the Ho Chi Minh City, which is also called as Saigon. We had booked a luxury apartment through Airbnb called the Mastery. From the classic French architecture to humongous skyscrapers, this city is undoubtedly Vietnam's biggest and most appropriately called the business capital. Just had one night to spend in Ho Chi Minh, we explored the Quen Hue walking street. This is a square that is free of any vehicles and is just open to the pedestrians. It is bordered by the city hall that was beautifully lit and has numerous French and Vietnamese restaurants around. The square was full of lights, interesting people, color, cute little pets taking an evening stroll. The aura and vibe of the Quen walking street was perfect idea of an awesome evening.
Hi! Name? Name? Maku! So cute!
After a captivating evening and a splendid night, it was time to bid adieu to Ho Chi Minh, which also means that our enthralling trip to Vietnam comes to an end. Luggage is packed and all set to go back home. We said, Tam Biet Vietnam, we will be back soon.
If you like this video, then do not forget to hit that like button. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't done already. If you missed out on watching the first part of the Vietnam trip, then please go down in the description box below and find the link out there. Hit on the notification bell so that you get notified whenever I upload a video and share it with your friends and family. I will be back with a super interesting video very, very soon. Till then, you stay happy and stay blushing. Bye!